Welcome to RSSTI TV 2020 brought to you by Wokhardt. I am Dr. Ruchi Shah, and on behalf of Wokhardt, RSSTI TV 2020, I welcome you all. I am glad to have with us today renowned diabetologist from Patna, Dr. Ajay Kumar sir. Sir is a consultant physician and diabetologist and director at Diabetes Care and Research Center. He has a rich clinical experience in managing diabetes patients. Welcome Dr. Ajay Kumar to the show. So, sir, based on your recent talk in RSSTI 2020 on a very interesting topic of attaining the treatment goals in type 2 diabetes, managing the total control with simplicity and convenience, we would like to know from you, could you explain the reasons for failure to achieve the good glycemic control in majority of the patients with type 2 diabetes?
I think clinicians across the world must appreciate that type 2 diabetes is fundamentally an asymptomatic disease. And obviously, if a patient doesn't have symptoms, he or she is unlikely to be very serious about having a good control of the blood sugar. At the same time, on the physician's perspective, this procrastination is the most important reason for failure to achieve the total glycemic control. What happens that we start with lifestyle modification and one or two oral antidiabetic drugs, and then at the appropriate time, we fail to intensify the treatment with appropriate changes, either in the oral medications or institution of insulin. And this is vitally important. If we can address the issue of understanding by proper communication with the patient so that they can appreciate the seriousness of the condition, and at the same time can motivate the doctors that they should be prescribing medications or treatment regimens at the appropriate time, and with the appropriate regimen.
Thank you so much, sir. So, sir, we would also like to know from you, what are the innovations in the science of insulin in the past decade?
I think we have to appreciate once again that insulin will be required by almost two-thirds of the patients of type 2 diabetes at any point of time to achieve what we call the total glycemic control. And let me first explain what do we understand with total glycemic control. We must attain the target HbA1c for the individual patient, and that is only possible if we can address both the fasting and the postprandial blood sugars. At the same time, I would include in total glycemic control that the patient should have minimal or no hypoglycemia, minimal or no weight gain, and most importantly, the insulin regimen should be simple, flexible, and convenient for the patient. And keeping that in view, if we look at the innovations of last one decade, I think the most fundamental change that we have seen is the extension of the basal insulin time action profile. We now have basal insulins which have a half-life of 25.4 hours, like insulin degludec. We also have glargine U300, which has a half-life which is close to 17 to 20 hours. So these are eminently suitable to be given once daily. But even more important is that for the first time, because of the unique molecular structure of insulin degludec, we can combine an ultra long acting basal insulin with a rapid acting insulin analog like insulin aspart. And that gives us a very beautiful insulin molecule, what we call IDEGAS, which can address both the fasting and the postprandial hyperglycemia. This was not possible earlier with glargine or detemir, because if you combine glargine or detemir with any rapid acting insulin analog, that would not be chemically possible. Either you will get very erratic absorption profile, or they have different pH at which they precipitate.
So, sir, the last question, based on your observation, what is your choice as a best insulin regimen in the clinical practice?
I just alluded to the fact of this very innovative insulin combination called IDEGASP, which is a combination of 30% insulin aspart with 70% insulin degludec. And obviously, it will address both the fasting and the postprandial hyperglycemia. And if you look at the clinical trial results, looking at its institution, either for initiation of insulin treatment or for intensification of insulin treatment. We must go back to the premise as to why basal insulin has been preferred to start insulin. Because it can be given once daily, it is very convenient for the patient, and it causes minimal hypoglycemia. Now, if you compare once daily basal insulin glargine with once daily IDEGASP, you are giving just one injection. You are not increasing the risk of hypoglycemia. you are achieving better HbA1c control, and because you are targeting both the fasting and the postprandial hypoglycemia. But we also appreciate that not all patients can control their diabetes with just one shot of insulin. So in due course of time, when insulin intensification is required, all that you need to do is to move from one shot of IDEGAS to two shots of IDEGAS. What is the data available? There is very robust data that if you compare once or twice daily IDEGAS with a stepwise increase in the basal insulin plus one prandial, what we call the basal plus going on to basal bolus regimen, we can clearly see that you can achieve similar glycemic control, lower risk of nocturnal hypoglycemia, and most important, one of the most simple regimens, because you are starting with one insulin and you are only intensifying with the same insulin. You are not putting the complexities of the insulin regimen to the patient that they have to use two different pens, two different insulin, two different titration algorithm, which makes life extremely complicated. So that's the reason I think IDEGAS is a game changer so far as insulin regimens are concerned.
Thank you so much, sir, for precisely and beautifully explaining about the insulin regimen and sharing your views on this very important total glycemic control with simplicity and convenience. Stay tuned to RSSDI TV 2020 brought to you by Wockhardt for more recent updates from the RSSDI 2020. Thank you very much.